Hi, I'm Alan D'Andrea from the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute. I'm the American Cancer Society professor there, and I'm the director of the Center for Women's Cancer at the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute. And so I'm primarily a basic scientist. I've spent most of my career working on DNA repair, how cells, when they're damaged, can elicit DNA repair mechanisms and survive. And we and others in the field have shown that cancer cells have a very strong ability to repair DNA and DNA double strand breaks. We have found over the years that a particular cancer, namely high-grade serous ovarian cancer, often results from defects in DNA repair. And because these ovarian cancers, as many as 50% of these ovarian cancers, have defects in DNA repair, these cells tend to be hypersensitive to a new class of drugs. And this new class of drugs is called, of course, PARP inhibitors. PARP inhibitors are now very rapidly working their way into the clinic. They're good drugs, they're oral drugs, they're generally well-tolerated drugs, and they seem to be effective in the treatment of some women with ovarian cancer, which is otherwise a very terrible disease. Ovarian cancer is awful to the extent that there's 24,000 cases a year in the United States and 18,000 deaths, and the disease usually develops at a very advanced stage. It's not recognized until a very advanced stage. So PARP inhibitors are a breath of fresh air. It's a new drug and a new class of drugs to treat ovarian cancers. However, already patients who are treated with PARP inhibitors are showing up to be resistant to PARP inhibitors. So a major focus of my own laboratory research in the last couple of years has been identifying mechanisms of resistance, how tumor cells become resistant to PARP inhibitors. And in that context, we found new mechanisms that tumors that become resistant to a PARP inhibitor often upregulate other DNA repair pathways or upregulate mechanisms for stabilizing their replication forks. And these tumors tend to be more sensitive to a new class of drugs called ATR inhibitors or CHK1 inhibitors. So a major feature of the work that I presented today was trying to find out creative ways to use combinations of drugs, combinations of PARP inhibitors and ATR inhibitors and CHK1 inhibitors for the treatment of ovarian cancer. A major part of that work has been the development of preclinical models. We use patient-derived xenograft models from mice, but most recently we've been using so-called organoid models, where we actually get biopsies of an ovarian cancer directly from a woman who's been recently diagnosed, take those biopsies of fresh tumor from the patient, grow these tumor cells out in vitro in these so-called organoid cultures, and these cultures grow out in a very short period of time, in only 7 to 10 days. And during that time, we can actually study these organoid cultures, examine different combinations of drugs, and try to determine what is the best combination of drugs to be used for the treatment of that organoid culture from that ovarian tumor from that patient. So this is an example of so-called precision medicine, is trying to adapt novel combinations of drugs for a particular tumor culture derived directly from an individual as a way of predicting the best drug therapy. So I think it's an exciting time to be working on DNA repair. As I said, I've been working in this field as a basic scientist for 30 years now, and it's obviously very compelling and fortunate that I think that some of this work now is actually reaching a point of translation where these discoveries can actually be used to treat this terrible disease.